Yeah, tunasema it's break 254. You will allow me to have a seat there, master. Yes, to all viewers back at home, DJ. To all viewers back at home, we welcome you to Break 254. Sam the host, DJ Lemonade. HW Freak Photography and Safaris. We have our guest who has arrived. Huyu nayo tunataka tupige sherehe tu na tuongee vitu yetu tu. Huyu hatutampatia random ati huyu anakuongelea nini hapana. Huyu nataka tupige shughuli venye inafaa. Tunaelewana? Introduce yourself, master.
My name's Humphrey Makendo. I'm saved. Coming from Dawio Freak and I'm pleased to be here.
Yes, coming from the way of Freak and you're blessed to be here. Just 1, 2, 3 questions. What do you do in the way of Freak?
I'm a videographer. I do videography. Apart from that, I'm also an editor. And I'm a mentor. I do a lot of stuff. Yeah. So basically, when you come to the way of Freak, that's the area of speciality. That's what I've been doing for quite a while. I can say it's been like around 15 years now in the game. Yeah.
Mtiangu, unasema wewe na miaka mko separate. So watu wasikuone hivi, si ndio? Yes, tumesema wewe ni Ham.
Yes, I am Humphrey Makendo.
Humphrey.
But
watu wanakuita nani?
Just Ham.
Yes, can I just to tell them, you know, wakisikia Dawi ya Freak, photography, or whatever. Some of us, we don't know the meaning of these words. Oh, video editing, sijui editors, sijui nini. Maybe what do you measure personally, wewe?
Well, basically the whole thing is cinematography. That is
cinematography.
Cinematography. That's where the area of speciality. That is from videography. That is covering events, that is shooting. People call it shooting in layman's language, but it's video coverage for events, be it a wedding, be it a koito, be it a conference, be it live streaming, and TV content as a whole. And after we have taken the video in the field or in studio, like what you are doing right now, we come and sit down and do the graphics and then removing the bad stuff, maybe things which we didn't want to be in the video. And then we also add other additives so that it can come out perfect. And apart from that, we also do photography. Dawi Afrik is a big institution in Eldoret. It's in Zion Mall. That is in Eldoret Zion Mall, Basement A. That's where we are located, and that's where we are streaming from. That's
Eldoret. You know, we are becoming a city. Wasengishu, is it Eldoret City or Wasengishu City?
It's Eldoret City.
Eldoret City.
Yeah.
So my question to you concerning the photography. We have the indoor and the outdoor, whatever. The charges, mtiangu tuongeletu hapo. Is it the same or different?
Let me say we cater for all our clientele. That is, we don't discriminate. Whenever you come in, depending with the package that you have, that is the requiring the budget that you have. That's what we sit down and then try to come up with something that befits you as a client. So we don't have, we have different packages for different groups. But depending with where you fit in, that's where we welcome you. So whenever, if you have an event, maybe you're out there, make sure you can visit us in Dawi Afrik and studio. We also do safaris, by the way.
Safaris, nini? Unajua mimi najua safaris ni kwa nje.
Safaris is tours and travel. We organize trips for organizations, for individuals. Maybe you want a retreat, you want to go for company, retreat. We'll organize, maybe you have a tour, because Kenya ni kubwa, you can travel. We'll organize all the logistics, and then you can just pay a certain amount which we'll agree on, and the places that you want to go, and you go enjoy yourself. Yeah.
Mtiango, the worst time yenye umewahi kuwa nayo kwa hii kazi yako. The worst time yenye labda ulitumwa uende mahali na mambo ikachemka. Unaweza tu naretia tu kidogo that situation.
Yeah. I've had a lot of challenges being in this field for quite a while. I've been able to be in this field by God's grace all that while. And one moment which I remember, kuna mali nilienda shoot somewhere in Nakuru. I know maybe that client ananiona. It was so embarrassing, you know. I had gone to cover an event, and then it was a family which had different issues. The parents had a graduation for one child, of which the family had lived unnamed, but the family had divorced. Now the husband was not supposed to see the child. And then I'm supposed to cover the event without knowing. So they told me, you just go and cover. Everything is covered.
So we covered a war.
Nika cover bana. Way. And then along the way, out of nowhere, nikajipata nime angukiwa. Imagine graduation iko kwa church, and then people pounce on you from different directions.
Reason.
And then nikanyanganywa camera. It was... in fact, it was damaged. Ikaangushwa chini, and then they told me, make sure you erase all the data. Without knowing where the problem was. For me, nimeenda kazi, but...
Kawoka kanza.
Kawoka kanza.
Sawa mtiangu. Now, maybe on the other side. The best, kenye umeienda mahali, baka ukajiambia nyewe, I've done it, manze.
Yeah, I've had a lot of moments.
The best, the one highlight.
The best, I can't really tell, but one of the best is I had this friend of mine, Captain Ian, who came to the show. And I talked to him, Nakakuja, we did something together. That was one of the epic moments, because watu ameniuliza hadi wa leo, where did you get this guy? No, he inspired a lot of people. Na akasema, if possible, nimrudishe tena. So, maybe soon.
Soon atarudi.
Atarudi.
Huyu captain, hata mimi nilifanya naye kazi na I'm getting some feedbacks ya ulitoa wapi mtu. Lakini, anapatikana watu yangu, wandege, watu wa Vieta, tunapatikana tu. Yes, shout out to Tichi Mishar Njoro Pius, wherever you are, director wa Vieta. Now, the course or the study about this issue, yote, photography, cinematography. Network?
Yeah.
Yes. How, unaweza tuambia tu, how is it? Because niko sure wengi wanaingia kwa journalism.
Mm-hmm.
And then I don't know journalism na hii kama ni same.
Yeah, the one are the same thing. When it comes to cinematography, basically, ni tuna major on film work. That is professional film, producing film content. That's why tunaita cinematography. That is high definition pictures, and then you do it with utmost creativity and utmost professionalism in it. Hii mambo na ambayo nasema, it's part of journalism. Nile tu ukisomea journalism utaguzia juu. Kama ni editing, kuna wale watu ambao nimekuwa nikimenta from campuses ambao wamesoma journalism. But one funny thing, unapata mtu aelewi hata kuedit na yeye ameingia a degree program ya journalism. So inakuwa challenge sana. When it comes to this profession as a whole, I've been studying it, na hata saizi, I'm still studying it. I've never stopped because it is very wide. When it comes to production, kuna ile part ya shooting, kuna post-production, ambayo ni editing, and then pia delivering that, ama sharing that product out there. So iko na kazi kubwa that it entails before you deliver the project.
The worst comment umewahi pata?
Let me say, kuna clients maybe hawajaelewa. Yeah. For you to produce maybe a work, ama a content, maybe ni your video ya wedding, before ujaju yo mtu, kuna angalia huyu mtu. Labda umemuinvite kwa wedding, atasimama hapo the whole day, hata labda haja kula. Na huja mkumbuka, lakini you expect him to cover the whole event. And then at the end of the day, hata wakati wa mtu anaitisha ile payment, inakuwa like stories and all that. And then kuna ile contempt, labda atakuonyesha madharau, unaona. Yet this guy amesimama kwa jua, labda amesimama, na ame struggle just to deliver some good content. But at times anakosa kwa appreciated. So your moment inakuanga the lowest kabisa.
So unajua wakati wengine uko kwa arusi. Na unajua ni lazima ucapture every moment. Every moment. Nimerudia hiyo, every moment. Bibi arusi akiingia, uko hivyo penye anaenda, akiteguka kidogo lazima ukue hapo. Uwa mna survive aje, because sisi wengine ni watu wa line. Pangeni line ya wazazi hapa, sijui ya nani hapa, marafiki, maanti. Ni mna survive ungu aje? Kwa sijui ona uwezi acha kamera iki shoot hewa, uende ukule. Niambiwe wewe personally, how do you survive in that?
Normally, inabidi unajipanga mapema. At times you wake up early, you eat well, no when the field. That's one rule yenye. Kama you are beginner, maybe you're doing it. Usi rely kwa chakula ya shere, maybe. Just eat mapema and then ukienda, chapa kazi kabisa. But mostly what we normally do, at times we go in a group. That is utapata kutakuwa na videographer, kutakuwa na photographer. So we eat in turn sometime. So that's how we do it.
Yeah. Sasa mti yangu uliongelea wakati fulani kulikuwa na war because of a graduation. Concerning that issue, yeah, parental. It's becoming a major issue, a very big major issue in our country and in the world, concerning the issue of parenthood. Wewe personally, how do you take this figure or this aspect the role of a father and a mother in the house?
Well,
in parenting, kindly. Remember, okay. Kuna watoto pale. How do you unachukulia aje your story?
Well, it's a topical issue which really needs discussion across all platforms, because hiyo ndo issue tumekuwa tunaface, especially with this generation. Tukiangalia, I'm a parent. I have a son. Na, I thank God for that. Na, the way I've learned, kuna mali the book of Proverbs, I'll base it on the Bible because that's the guidance enye huwa nafuata sana. This book that is in Proverbs 22 verse 6, the Bible says, train up a child in the way that he should go, and when he grows old, he'll never depart from it.
You.
Yeah. So this one thing I've always based my parenting skills on. I've always trained my son and every other person or any other child how to fear God, to revere God, and I've always trained them also on praying. Apart from that, I also teach in the church. I teach in Sunday school, and every moment I find chance ya kuongea na watoto ama vijana ama any person mwenye ako na ile umri ya bado anakuwa, I always measure that verse nikiwafunza about fearing God and revering Him. Because that's the most important thing. The moment you leave God outside the equation, that's where you fail as a parent. Wakati, that is, as a parent, parents mali tuna fail, ni wakati we don't instill the values, the right values, scriptural values in our children. And that's why tumepata society imenda wayward. That's why we are raising kids as single parents. That's why we are raising kids wana end up kuwa gay, wengine wana end up kuwa lesbians, and we don't see the issue with that.
Mtiango, umeongelea lugha ingine hapo hivyo, wacha ni kuulize swali.
Yeah.
Niliuliza hii swali nikafukuzwa. Na nikaambiwa usiwai niulize hii swali na sitaki kufikiria that thing.
Mm.
Wewe sahi, boys wako, kijana yako, your only son, your lovely one.
Yeah.
Yes, the hair, amekuja kukua kwa nyumba na amekuja kusema, daddy, nimepata mrembo. Umelewa?
Yeah.
Unamwambia congratulations.
Mm-hmm.
Unamuliza, anakuambia, atakuja kesho. Kesho tu hivi tu saa tano, mchana. Another boy comes in, anakuambia wewe ndio mrembe yangu. Niambie ndugu yangu utafanya nini?
Well, that's how we are raising our kids.
Yes, mrembe yangu na amekuletea boy.
Okay, as a parent, I think I'll look at it in this way. Antangalia, is this child amefika ile umri ya kusettle?
Mtiangu, utasettle. Me, no. I'm talking about a man bringing a man.
A man, okay. Oh, sorry.
Yes,
sorry,
yes, yes.
I won't agree to that because one thing, Don Nesema, the way you raise up a child matters a lot.
Bwana, wait, I know the way you raise. Mm. But kumbuka, our toto, we usually let them go when enter universities, they stay alone. In high school, they stay alone. Sorry, they stay with teachers, fine, and lecturers and whatever. But it's like they stay alone. Whatever they learn, whatever they see is what they put in. Tunelewa?
Yes.
It is so minimal, wewe mzazi, the time that you are with your child, ni kidogo sana compared to the time ako peke yake. So kama ni wewe amekuja na kukuambia, daddy, mimi naitwa Brayo na nimepata kevo na kevo kesho anakuja na inafaa tuoane. Kama wewe utasema utamfanyia nini? Ama utafanya nini?
First of all, nita rebuke that in love because one thing, watoto upotea. Na this generation yenye tunaishi, sorry to say this, and not against any person kufanya vitu yenye nafanya. But one thing I want you to remind you, maybe ukiwa mdogo, there's something they instilled in you. Yeah? And that's what nilikuwa nasema, it's so important the way you raise a child. Because utapata mtoto akifunzwa maadili mema akiwa mdogo, hivyo ndo atashika. Hata aende wapi, that's what I will atashika. Because those words zitamtafuta kila mara. Now, in this case, umeleta mtu wakiume, and then when wakiume, introducing to a parent, then I will say no. Why? Because it's not biblical. It's against what mimi na believe. And I will just rebuke you in love, nikwambie, my son or my daughter, this is not the way to go. This what I've trained you. And you can look at me and your mom, Nona, are we going the same direction in your own end? These things, it's more of conformity, as the word, the book of Romans says. Do not be conformed to the ways and patterns of this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind so that you may know what is true and holy before the Lord. So, wakati wanashika iyo, they will not be conformed. But the moment wanatoka, na wewe kama parent, you don't have time for your child. Itafika mahali, uyu mtoto wakati, the people that are spend now, ni Netflix, nona, na Netflix saizi ime mwaga all the trash. Every program, every content in yona deliver, it's all about your sexual orientation. Nona, so that's the sad truth. But ukikaa chini na mtoto wako, especially now that we are in the holidays, make sure you sit down your child na umzungumzie umwambie, my son, I don't know whom you are seeing, but the way we should go, I want to know you, like, what's your sexual orientation as a person? Jua your child from that level. Don't overlook, because sometime ukiangalia at teenage years unapata mtoto maybe amefika that adolescent stage tayari amesha discover, so ataanza kuleta aseme I have a boyfriend, I have a girlfriend. Na unaangalia mtoto wako, maybe she's a girl, and then haumwoni akizungumzia, na maybe ako boarding school, and then you're not asking her what's your sexual orientation. Utakuwa kwa surprised if you don't sit down your child and every other time remind him of the promises of God and teaching him in God's ways, so that hata grow aende mbali hata I depart.
Thank you. We have Titus K. Tetas amesema following Tobias Ocho, nimeja Sophie Muno amesema hii imeweza. Kipto Kade amesema tumedonjo tuanguke na Yesu. Yes, lastly, as we wind up the show for today, tumesema leo tunataka tupige tu shereki muziki. And I want you to advise the families and the parents wenye wako in crisis. You know, it's hard. And maybe it is not, ilikuwa lazima ifanyike. Na ingine ikuwa lazima, but imefanyika. Maybe you can just give in 1 minute, give them a piece of advice, maybe biblical or according to the current situation, so that tuingie kwa muziki kidogo.
True. It's a sad truth, seeing families breaking down. And families inafika mali unapata you're remaining as a single parent. It's a very sad truth, seeing such issues happening in our society. Now, maybe you are one of them and you're looking at me right now, but I want to encourage you that all is not lost. All is not gone down the drain. You can still pick yourself up. You can still move on. Now, pia, don't, one thing in Nimesha study, whenever you, if you are a parent, never deny your child to see the other partner. Hata kama umekosana na your spouse, that is your husband or your wife. Never ever, because at the end of the day, ita vunja huyo mtoto. It will break that child down. Na eventually, atakuwa na zile issues when ana grow up in future. So make sure you sit down with your child. Ataka kuna issues, try to co-parent, try to work things out for the sake of that child na itakuwa muhimu. Because that's what God ana require from us. Wakati unaenda aside, unaona like you can do it on your own, well and good, go ahead. But at the end of the day, umevunja huyo mtoto na future huyo mtoto.
Manzi, thank you, Ham. Yeah. You have introduced a new topic. This topic, we are going to handle it very well the last Friday of the month. We are going to handle this very, very, very well. We are going to have so many guests. We are going to bring a young couple. We are going to bring a pastor. We are going, hata ikiwezekana tutaleta mpaka wanaitwa shehe. Hata shehe atakuja tueleze kuhusu maneno. Yes, so that is the next the last Friday of the month. Apart from that, tomorrow in the same context of fatherhood, tomorrow we have a big event for father and sons. Father and sons, it will be happening at in Eldoret, first of all. The place is called Cornerstone, Missionary College. Cornerstone. Is it AIC Cornerstone? Iko pale Kapsoya, somewhere up there, kwa hiyo mlima. Hapo jutu kwa mlima, mahali penye kulikuwa na Biblia usema na sayare. Hapo. Kindly, all fathers. We are repeating, all fathers, wherever you are, we welcome you to that event. It will be a father and son affair. Dress code, kuja ukiwa sporty, just wear sporty. We shall have more activities, tutakuwa na reverence, tutakuwa na, that reverence is talks, yeah? We shall have a lot of eating. We shall eat, that is obvious. And then we shall have sessions where father and son sessions, we shall have son sessions, father sessions, and then we shall come together and then we combine and we take the notes ahead. Wazazi na nyinyi wazee, tunawaambia tu vizuri. Mtoto wako asikuje akuambie mimi naitwa Chero na nimekuletea Chebet. Hiyo tumekataa.